Let's work through the following related rates problem together. So here's the situation. Sand is being dumped from the back of a truck at a rate of 17 cubic feet per minute, and its coarseness is such that it forms a pile in the shape of a cone, whose base diameter is always twice its height. How fast is the height of the pile increasing when the base is 6 feet around? Okay, so let's follow our related rates steps to solve this problem. So the first two steps of the related rates process are to 1, read the problem carefully, and 2, to draw a picture and label it. And as we draw our picture, we want to label things that never change or constants as numbers, and then label things that change as variables. So we've already read the problem. Basically, the situation here is we have sand that's being dumped from the dump truck, and it's forming a pile. And then I kind of already have a picture set up here. So you'll see that I already have a few variables labeled on my picture. These are things that are changing during the course of this scenario. So we have the sand that's coming from the dump truck, and I actually might add one thing to the picture here. The sand being dumped from the dump truck into the pile, that's volume of sand, right? That's being added to the pile. So I'm just going to label that as volume coming out of the dump truck and into the pile. And then actually in our pile here, you see I've labeled H the height of the cone shaped pile, and then R the radius. And those are things that are changing as that sand is being dumped into the pile. Okay, so we have our picture set up here. We kind of know the scenario that's going on. So what's the next step? The next step is to write down the rates that we know and the rates that we're trying to find, and make those match up with the variables we have so far. Okay, so what rates do we know from the problem? Well, in the very first sentence, we're told that sand is being dumped at a rate of 17 cubic feet per minute. Okay, so that's a rate of change of volume. So I'm going to call that dV/dt, and it equals 17 cubic feet per minute. Okay, what else? Let's see. Just kind of skimming through the problem here, I'm looking to see if I see any more rates mentioned. So, forms a pile in the shape of a cone, diameter is always twice its height. How fast is the height of the pile increasing when the base is 6 feet around? Okay, so that tells me the rate I'm looking for. How fast is the height of the pile increasing? So what I'm actually looking for is dH/dt. And that's all the information I'm given about rates in this problem. And specifically, I'm looking for dH/dt when base is 6 feet around, and we'll deal more with that piece of information later. Okay, so what's next in our process? So after we have our rates established, we want to find a relationship between our variables. So I need to find a relationship that includes the volume and the height of this pile and somehow relates them. Okay, so very often this is some sort of common geometry formula. In this case, our sand pile is a cone, so that suggested that we're probably going to want to use the volume of a cone formula. So what's that formula? The volume of a cone is 1/3 pi r squared h. Okay, so this is volume of cone. Okay, so this makes sense, right? This formula relates the volume of the pile to its height, so that's good. We found a relationship between the variables and wrote the equation. So what's step 5? Step 5 is to eliminate variables from the equation for which we do not know the rate of change, or except for the variable we're actually looking for its rate of change. But basically, if there's a variable in this equation that we don't have information about, we want to somehow eliminate it. And that actually happens in this situation. So look at your volume formula here. Volume, well, we know about volume. We know dV/dt, so we want to keep that. 1/3 pi, those are just constants. R squared. I don't know anything about r squared, and I'm not looking for r squared. And then I've got h, and that's the variable I'm actually concerned about, that I'm looking for dH/dt, so I want to keep that. So I need to somehow eliminate r squared from my equation. Okay, so I'm going to dedicate a little section to our work here to eliminate eliminating R squared. That's going to be our next next challenge that we need to do. Okay, so whenever you need to eliminate a variable, there's several things that could happen, but usually it's going to be some sort of extra piece of information that's given to you in the problem, or maybe some sort of geometry trick you need to use. So let's read the problem again and see if we're given any additional information about that radius. Okay, so notice here, kind of in the middle of the problem, it says it forms a pile in the shape of a cone whose base diameter is always twice its height. Okay, so that gives us some specific information about the shape of the cone. So let's see if we can work with that information a little bit. Okay, the base diameter is always twice its height. So let's try to write a relationship to represent that fact. Okay, the diameter of the cone is twice the radius, right? So first let's write this maybe like this. So diameter equals 2 times height, right? The diameter is always twice its height. Okay, but the diameter we can write as 2r. So 2r equals 2h. Well, that just gives me r equals h. Well, that's a really useful relationship, right? This tells me that the radius of the cone is always equal to its height. So that's going to help me eliminate r squared, because if r equals h, then I can just write r squared is h squared. Okay, so now I just want to rewrite my volume formula then to reflect this. So 1/3 pi, well, r is h, so this is h squared times h, which I can write as v equals 1/3 pi h cubed. Okay, so we've eliminated the variable we wanted to get rid of, and now we only have v and h. V we know, dv dt we know that is, and dh dt we're looking for. So now we're good. So what's the next step? The next step is to take the derivative implicitly with respect to time. So I want to take the derivative of this entire relationship with respect to time. So I'm thinking of v as a function of time, and also h as a function of time, because both those things are changing with time. So when I take the derivative of those variables, I just need to remember to use a chain rule. So what does that look like? Well, the derivative of v is going to be dv dt. Okay, then on the right-hand side, you know, I use the power rule to bring this 3 down from the h. So that's going to give me 3 times 1/3 pi h squared. But then because h is a function of time, I need to multiply by its derivative with respect to time, which is dh dt. Okay, so if we simplify this a little bit, we get 3 times 1/3 is just 1. So we get pi h squared dh dt. So this is our derivative relationship. This gives us a relationship between the way the volume is changing, the volume of the pile is changing, and the height of the pile is changing. And we see that that relationship depends upon the height of the pile. Okay, so what's our next step? Well, the next step in the process is to, if you're following along with your steps, is to plug in values that never change. So this is referring to any rates that we know. Okay, so we want to go ahead and plug in any rates that we know. And if we scroll back up, remember that we know dv dt is 17. So I can go ahead and plug that value into this problem. And, okay, so I'm going to plug in dv dt equals 17. And if I do that, I get 17 equals pi h squared dh dt. Now, I'm going to go ahead and actually solve this relationship for dh dt, because remember, dh dt is what we're actually interested in. So if I do that, I get dh dt, and I'm just going to divide the pi h squared, so I get 17 over pi h squared. Okay, so we're not quite done yet, but we're close. So what's kind of the last step in our process? So the last step is to plug in what we call particular moment information. And we always want to wait until the very end to do this. But in the related rates problem, you're always told to find the rate when such and such is true. So we're looking for DHCT at a particular point in time, and now's the point in the process where we actually want to plug in that particular moment information. So what was our particular moment information for this problem? Okay, it says, how fast is the height of the pile increasing when the base is 6 feet around? Okay, so we want to plug in particular moment information, which in our case, in this problem, is when the base is 6 feet around. Okay. Well, this is maybe a little bit challenging particular moment information compared to some of the other problems we've seen, because if you look at our DHDT formula right here, the variable that we see in that formula is H, right? So we want to have some value of H to plug in there, but our particular moment information doesn't tell us anything directly about the height of the pile. It tells us we're looking at the instant when the base is 6 feet around. So somehow we have to take that piece of information, that fact, and translate it into information about the height of the pile. Okay, so we need to translate this into information about the height of the pile. H, so that we actually have something to plug in to our DHDT formula. Okay, so let's just kind of work through this logically. So what are we told? We're told when the base is 6 feet around. Okay, so the around is kind of the key word there. So this is telling us we're looking at the moment when the circumference, right? The base is 6 feet around. That's referring to the circumference of the base. So circumference equals 6. Okay, well, what's the expression for the circumference of the base? Well, the base of the cone is just a circle. Okay, so the circumference of a circle is 2 pi r. Okay, if we solve for r in this relationship, we get 6 over 2 pi, which is 3 over pi. Okay, so we've kind of done one step of translation so far. When the base is 6 feet around is equivalent to saying when the radius is 3 over pi feet. But what did we figure out just a few steps ago? Remember, we discovered that for this particular cone, r equals h, remember? This cone is very special. It has a special relationship between its radius and height, and r equals h. So that's going to help us out a lot here. So recall, r equals h. So r equals 3 over pi feet means h must equal 3 over pi feet as well. Okay, and this is what we were going for, right? We wanted some information about the particular moment in terms of the height of the pile, and we found it. When the base is 6 feet around, the height is 3 over pi feet. And now we just plug and chug. So DHDT was 17 over pi h squared. So if I plug in for h, that's 3 over pi quantity squared in the denominator. So that's 17 over pi times 9 over pi squared, okay, which is going to give me 17 over, and then in the denominator I'm going to have 9 over pi. So this is division of fractions, so I can change that to multiplication by the reciprocal. And so then my final answer would be 17 pi over 9, and my units were feet per minute. So this is the rate of change of the height of the pile at the particular moment when the base is 6 feet around.